all.
Okay.
I'll be honest with you.
Okay.
Why Shadab is coming in a super over?
Okay.
Why Fakhar is not taking a strike? Why is he not playing in a circle as an opener? Mm. I mean, like, look, there is a lot of things that are debatable. I'm just not going to go all gun blazing right now because Pakistan is Sunday coming up, has a big Sunday coming up. And it's against India now.
Fielding भी नहीं करवाई, keeping नहीं करवाई, तो fielding भी पूरे overs नहीं करवाए। आप उस बच्चे के साथ ज्यादती कर रहे हैं, उसके साथ पाकिस्तान के साथ ज्यादती कर रहे हैं, पाकिस्तान की क्रिकेट के साथ ज्यादती कर रहे हैं। ये क्रिकेट के जो फैंस हैं, इनके साथ ज्यादती कर रहे हैं आप। अपनी अना के लिए ना, अपना नाम बढ़ाने के लिए ये काम कर रहे हैं, जिसकी वजह से ये हाल हमें देखना पड़ा कि सुपर ओवर में भी यूएसए से नहीं हम जीत सके।
और आप वसीम भाई ये देखें, हमारे ओपनर कौन है T20 के?
फखर
बाबर रिजवान और बाबर सुपर ओवर में आई नहीं।
Yes, this speaks volume.
Fakhar ne kyun nahi face kiya? Fakhar left hander hai, usko zyada achhi hit lagti
hai. They need my sport, they need our sports, they need my voices and their voices. I understand the disappointment. Very disappointed, Aaron. I'll be very honest with you. I am very disappointed because I predicted this with Mr. Guppy. Martin is my witness. I said, Martin, it doesn't look good.
You were a bit cautious before
it's
the
not looking good. I was cautious in the game, but I just told him directly. I said, listen, it's not looking good for me. So because I know the players inside out,
yeah,
and how they're going to behave on the pitch, and that's exactly what they did.
But brilliant, brave cricket from the US team, especially in that super over, the all important one.
But the prophecy from Martin Guptill to get to a super over, this man,
yeah,
is
exactly.
He predicted this would maybe go the way of
the
USA.
The
and then
so he
said
the
S-word.
The culprit is here.
He said the S-word,
yeah,
and here
apologize.
We are.
Exactly.
We had a super over, and you know,
you said that.
Credit to...
Maybe because I've been involved in so many of them.
Yeah, you did.
Somebody else's turn.
It was credit to...
And not too long ago, he predicted... the almost perfect score for
second game of the tournament.
Yeah, and well, that's Martin Guptill. But Marty, help us relive those moments,
yeah,
because talking about the brilliance and the bravery of the US team, especially in that super over. Rewatching this back now, what do you make of the effort that they? Because of course, as Pakistan fans, we were more focused on where the ball was being delivered. Amir looked extremely under pressure, but 7 runs. Only coming off of wides, that's got to be disastrous.
Yeah, that's not ideal for them, is it? It's in normal play, you know, without being a super over, you don't want to give up any wides. I can see what he's trying to do, and it's just an execution error. Unfortunately, he's done it 3 or 4 times in the over, and what makes it worse is that the USA got runs off those as well. They took a single, so you know it adds up. And there's obviously the first ball of the over, a little short and wide, and a little QN for 4. And obviously that throw from Rizwan there was probably a bad option. He should have held on to it. You know, that adds up as well, an overthrow. And then, yeah, just sort of compounded from there. And you can see the frustration on Amir's face. And I think he let that frustration get to him in his execution. And he wasn't thinking clearly about what he wanted to do. He was worried about what happened before instead of just making sure that he knew what he wanted to do that next ball and just go at it 100%.
I think the thought process was he got us back in the game, Shaheen and then Amir. And it's probably a good idea to just give him another over, but I thought he was a tired man.
He did look tired.
Come on, I would have given this ball throw up to either one option. I wouldn't go for second option. Shaheen, come here. You're reversing the ball. Listen, this is the field. Just go out there, just yaar kar de yaar, khatam kar yaar. 10 runs hai tumhare paas, 10 se zyada dene yaar, ye limit hai.
I'm just interested before we move on as well. So you think that Amir was the wrong choice to bowl that super over?
Look, he given his best already.
Yeah.
Just before the one super over, because he was putting everything that he had, and when I just saw him as a fast bowler, I'm saying that if you ask me to put that kind of a same exertion into that next over, I wouldn't be able to do it. Mm. Reason why? Because he's trying to do the right thing. But you know, what shook him is the left-hander, right?
Yeah.
We all get that.
Yeah.
But the thing is, execution is not right. But the execution has to be right. The reason why? Because she's tired.
Yeah.
I mean, he got us back in the game. But mera ye khayal tha, shine ko over dete, khatam karte, and then would have been so easy. Look, hume deserve nahi karte the match jeetna.
Yeah.
देखो सिंपल सी बात है यार, बात बुरी लगेगी, पाकिस्तान डिजर्व नहीं कर रहा था जीतना.
Who would you have bowled, Hafiz, Yunus?
I will go with Naseem or Shaheen straight away. Not with any other option.
Maybe Harris.
Yep. You know, he was hot off that last over.
Why is that? Because from last 4 or 5 years, Amir was, you know, out of the team. So it's hard for, you know,
for
sometimes.
Him to, yeah.
Yeah, as a, not as a youngster, but as a regular pro, it's hard for you to sometimes, you know, you bowl that length. So I think it was hard for him too at that moment.
Yeah, and we'll leave the batting from Pakistan in the super over now.
Do we have to?
Yes, we do, unfortunately. And I want to start from the choices to send in as well, because we're all debating it while sitting in the green room watching this. Iftikhar and Fakhar, the right choice to send in this moment?
I think these two were the right choice, but I would go Fakhar to face because the left-hand fast bowler is bowling to you. You can get out on a first ball. But if you are there, you can hit three sixes to him quite easily, because if I'm facing a off spinner, it's quite easy for me to hit three sixes rather than a left arm spinner. If left arm spinner will come in, I will ask my left handed batsman to go and face the first ball. So these are the small things. Obviously they didn't do well. That's the reason we lost this game. The whole, like right from the start of the game, we never had any moment where we feel that we are winning this game.
Yeah. Behind the eight ball.
We always behind the game. We always just trying to catch up. But we never hold it that game in our hands. Some way we can controlling it.
Good.
So
good
I
point.
Think we never deserve at the, as Shoaib bhai said, and I'm obviously, you know, it's disappointing way I'm saying that, but we never deserve to win this game.
चले मैच समरी के ऊपर एक और नजर डाल लेते हैं, रिफ्रेश कर दे, because जाहिर है हमने सुपर ओवर के ऊपर काफी बात की, but let's take a look at how we reached at that point in the game. Right from the toss, Pakistan were a little bit under pressure. They were put into bat first and ended up with 159 on the board. And you can see Babar was a bit, you know, hesitant to go for those bigger boundaries. But Shadab, when he came in, he was purely there. He was well settled. He looked good out there. And Shaheen with that fairy 23 as well with the bat. Iftikhar ने भी आके थोड़ा सा contribute किया है. उनकी जो USA की bowling थी, Kenjhingay ने 3 wickets जी लिए अपने 4 overs में. Netravalkar ने 4 overs में 2 wickets लिए, giving away 18 runs. So they did keep Pakistan on their toes, especially in that first half. लेकिन अगर आप उनकी batting देखें USA की, तो the captain Monang Patel 50 of 38, and of course Aaron Jones the star in that first game as well for US, again scoring 36, not out. Andrew Scott with 35 as well. And with the ball, Pakistan were struggling throughout, but Amir and Harris managed to pull it back. Naseem also giving away 26 runs in his 4 overs, and all three bowlers picked up 1 wicket each. But in the end, the match got tied, and then we all saw what happened after that. But let's take a look at where that puts Pakistan and USA on that points table. So there you have it, USA with 2 wins in 2 and 4 points and a positive net run rate as well. India, of course, just below them. And Pakistan is waqt ab thoda mushkil mein un nazar aa rahe hain, because ab agla match unke liye bahut zaruri ho gaya hai jeetna, but just you know, unable to pull it off tonight. And Erin losing out on not just the points, but of course the net run rate. But that's irrelevant right now, because there are no points for Pakistan.
It is irrelevant, but I think it will become relevant now. This loss to Pakistan really makes this pool very difficult and very challenging. We've been figuring out the certain permutations, but we have a situation now where potentially it will all come down to net run rate. So Pakistan, we want to win. We want to win big for our next couple of matches. But we talk about the captaincy, where things went wrong. How about for a man where things went absolutely right today? The very, very proud captain of the underdogs of America, Monang Patel, player of the match performance. USA were just up for the challenge, Shoaib. They were emulating just from their very bones how much this meant to them. And, you know, if we talk about that extra 1%, I feel like the energy that they brought, that their fielding was exceptional as well, right from ball one. Even in that super over, the way that they were backing up, running those wides against Amir, the intensity and the intent was there in a way that I just feel like the men in green didn't have today.
I think they also made a critical mistake by not giving over to Ali. I would reckon I would have gone with Ali.
For the super over?
Yeah, for the super over. Okay. I think that Pakistan had a chance. And imagine had Fakhar batting against this left-hander. would have been a different story altogether. They made a critical error. They were shaky a bit, but their attitude was good. But they also had this method towards their madness, of this attitude of theirs, which is absolutely fine. And they have showcased that attitude, that translate that they can win matches. And of course, they were better team, better combination, very sensible batters. They were playing runner ball. Had they had the experience of playing the World Cups one before this, they would have won this match, as Yunus said, at least two or three overs before.
A lot of scenarios playing up.
And up roha masla ye nahi yaar. Ab dekhen yaar ab situation pe na. Ab sari dunia baat kar rahi hogi. Sare bande Pakistan ko udaayenge. Theek hai, banta bhi hai. Pehla hi match, कोई पता नहीं किसने बैटिंग करनी है, किसने स्ट्राइक लेनी है, किसने एंकर करना है, किसने मारना है. इफ्तिखार आ रहा है, चल रहा है काम.
रोल नहीं है.
और शदाब यार किधर आ गया है? शदाब का काम ये तरता. मुझे 40 नहीं चाहिए शदाब के, मुझे 3 आउट चाहिए. दो.
That's a fair point.
It's सिंपल सी बात है. मुझे दो पॉइंट दे दो.
His major role is as
exactly.
he is in the team as a bowling all rounder. He is not a batting all rounder. Or you can tell him that you are a batter, yeah, and you can, you know, bring a proper spinner. Huh. So he can bat like as a, you know, he can be in the team like as a batter.
But a lot of inspiration, yeah, Yunus, to draw from the opponent team. Aap seekhte hain apne opponents se kis tarah wo aapko outsmart kar rahe hote hain. Agar hum USA ki batting dekhen, itni brave aur spirited batting lag nahi raha tha ki pehli baar Pakistan ko wo kisi bhi international match mein face kar rahe hain. ठीक है, बाकी सारे एडवांटेजेस जो हमने उनको दे दिए, जो हम कह सकते हैं कि चले देवर फेमिलियर विद डैलस.
देखिए ये भी नहीं है ना, हम अगर पिच की बात कर रहे हैं तो अटैक कौन कर रहा है?
बिल्कुल.
ये भी तो देखें, एक वहां पे आपको स्पिन बॉलिंग मिल रही है ना. आपको ये तो नहीं चले कि हम अगर हम बात करें कि चलिए ये न्यूयॉर्क की पिच है तो हम अगर टॉस हार जाएंगे तो शायद हम मैच हार जाएं. तो देखिए अगर, और फिर जब हमारे रिजवान को एक अच्छा बॉल हुआ, उसके बाद चलो कैच भी अच्छा हो गया, उसके बाद क्या हुआ? उस्मान खान कैसे आउट हुए, फ़खर जमान कैसे आउट हुए? अच्छा, अब फिर एक और यहाँ पे हम डिबेट कर सकते हैं कि फ़खर ऐसी बैटिंग क्यों कर रहे हैं, क्या वजह है इसकी? हमने तो उनको कभी ऐसा नहीं देखा, वो तो बस स्टैंड एंड डिलीवर होता है उनका. तो आज वो पीछे हट के खेल रहे हैं, तो ये उनका गेम ही नहीं है. उनका गेम तो देखें, उनके पास तो पावर हिटिंग मौजूद है ना, वो खड़े खड़े छक्के मारते हैं, तो वो क्यों ऐसा खेल रहे हैं? तो ये भी एक वजह होती है, जब आप अप एंड डाउन इतने हो जाते हो नंबर वाइज, तो फिर आपको अपना गेम ही याद नहीं होता कि मैं अब क्या गेम खेलूं. अगर आपने नीचे से आगे वो 7-8 ओवर में ही बैटिंग करनी है, अगर देखें अगर मैं बैटिंग करूंगा तो मेरे पास तो अब मैं सिंगल तो नहीं खेल सकता वहाँ पे, मुझे हर हाल में कुछ क्रिएटिव शॉट खेलने हैं. और अगर मैं एज ए ओपनर खेलता हूँ तो मुझे पता है कि मुझे 6 ओवर का पावर प्ले मिल रहा है, जिसमें हल्का सा मुझे रूम मिलेगा तो मैं जो है ना ऊपर से मैं बाउंड्री ले लूँगा, और थोड़ा सा अच्छी लेंथ में मिलेगा तो मैं छक्के मार दूँगा. तो जब अगर मैं नीचे आऊँगा 6-7 और के बाद, तो फिर मैं उस वक्त तो नहीं कर सकता क्योंकि बाउंड्रीज पे फील्डर्स खड़े हुए, तो या तो मैं रैम शॉट खेलूंगा या फिर मैं कहीं और शॉट खेलूंगा. तो ये वो हम ये नहीं कह रहे हैं, हम देखें ये बात बिल्कुल भी हम यहाँ पे कभी भी, क्योंकि हम इस टीम के लिए खुद क्रिकेट खेले हुए हैं और ये हमारे जूनियर्स हैं, हमारे सामने हमारे साथ खेलते हुए ये सीनियर हो गए. अब हम कभी नहीं चाहेंगे कि हम बाबर को लेट डाउन करें या मोहम्मद रिजवान को लेट डाउन करें या शुएब अख्तर जो है वो शहनशाह अफरीदी को के पीछे पड़ जाएंगे. बात असल में ये है कि हमें ये अंडरस्टैंड करना है कि इट्स नॉट अबाउट अस, इट इज़ अबाउट टीम. तो फिर आप अगर जो डिसीजन